We are left with the design of your base lamp. So unlike the previous cases, here we cannot just provide the minimum thickness and the minimum reinforcement. We have to design the base lamp due to the upward soil pressure and all the downward loads. Okay, so first of all we need to calculate the upward soil pressure, which will be gamma H plus T, where H plus T is this total height of the tank, H is the height of wall, and T is the thickness of your base lamp. Okay, so we will have to assume the thickness. So let us assume the thickness of base lamp to be the same as that of the wall. So the wall thickness was 350 mm, so I am taking the same as here also. So the force will be, so the pressure will be 43.5 kN per meter square. Here gamma is the water pressure, okay, because this is the main downward force which is acting. So the upward soil pressure will be gamma into H plus T, as the water pressure will be distributed along the base lamp. Okay. Now, as I have explained to you, we need to project the base lamp outside the walls in each direction, because to prevent upliftment, the upward force has to be counterbalanced by the downward force. So when we provide the projection beyond the wall, the soil weight on this projection will add to the downward force, which will help us in counteracting the upward force. Okay, so first we need to calculate how much projection is required. Too large projection will also be not beneficial for your tank wall, because if we provide a very large projection, then overall the downward weight will increase very large, and this downward weight may lead to settlement of the soil below. Okay, so we have to provide the optimum projection so that the upward pressure is exactly counterbalanced by the downward pressure. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. So the base lamp is projected beyond the walls of the tank because downward weight of soil on the projected portion, this and on the back side also, will balance the upward soil pressure. So let us assume that this projection we are providing as same on all sides, that is x. Okay, so this is x, 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 and similarly on the back side also. Okay, so I have made this diagram here. Okay, this is the long wall, short wall, top slab, which we have already designed, and this is the base slab with projection x in all directions. Now we will first of all calculate all the loads acting on this base lamp. So what are the different loads acting? We will start from the top. Weight of top slab acting in downward direction, weight of long walls, weight of the short walls, self weight of base slab. Okay, then weight of soil on the projected portion also, this is also a downward weight, and there is only one upward weight, that is the upward soil pressure acting below the base slab. So we have to calculate all these forces one by one. Okay, so let me make, I have made here the proper dimensions of your tank which we have till now, so that we can calculate the weights easily and the loads easily. Now let us look at the different dimensions which we have found out till now. So starting from the top, we have a top slab whose length is 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35 meter. Okay, because 10 is the inner dimension of your long wall and 4 meter is the outer inner dimension of your short wall. So the total length will be 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35, and the width will be 4 plus 0.35 plus 0.35. okay, and the thickness of this top slab is 0.15 meter. Now we have long walls of height 4 meter, its thickness is 0.35 meter, and the length of long wall is 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35 meter. The short wall has height 4 meter, thickness 0.35 meter, and its inner length is 4 meter. The base slab is 350 mm thick, we have assumed now, and its projection is x on all sides. Okay, so we have this much till now. Now I have made the front elevation and the side elevation of this tank. So if we look the tank from front, we will have this as the long wall 10 meter, this thickness of short wall will be shown like this. Okay, if you see from the front, this is the top slab, this, and this is the base slab with projections x this here and x here. Okay, now if we see from side, that is elevation from B side, so we will have this short wall here of 4 meter inner length, long wall 0.35 meter thick, 0.35 meter thick, x projection, x projection. Okay, so I hope this diagram is clear to you. Now we will find the different weights acting on this base slab. So let us start from top. The top slab weight of top slab will be the volume of the top slab into the density. So density will be 25, as this is a RCC top slab. So its weight will be its volume. So length into width into thickness. So length will be 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35. Its width will be 4 plus 0.35 plus 0.35. Okay. And its thickness is 150 mm, 0.15, and density is 25. So we get this as the weight of your top slab. Then weight of long wall. Weight of long wall will be height into length into thickness of long wall into 25. Okay, so height is 4 meter. The length is 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35, and the thickness is 0.35. Okay, into 25 into 2, because there are two long walls. Now for short wall, so short wall will have height 4 meter, thickness 0.35 meter, and only consider 4 meter. Why? Because when we have calculated the long wall volume of the long wall, we have already calculated this much thickness, okay, and this much thickness also we have already calculated here. Okay, now for this we will need only 4 meter length for the calculation of short wall. So here 4 into thickness 0.35 into 4, height into 25 into 2 will give the short wall. Now weight of base slab will be so total length of base slab will be 10 plus 0.35 plus 0.35 up to the long walls. Okay, and beyond that it will be x and x plus x. So 10.7 plus 2x, similarly 4.7 plus 2x into 0.35 is the thickness of your base slab into 25. So this will give you this load weight of the base slab in terms of x. Now the weight of projected portion will be, so for this let me make the plan of this wall of this tank. This is your tank, okay, and it is covered by a top slab. Okay, now this, let me make it with the help of another color. If you look from the top, this is the base slab and this is the top slab, because base slab is projected outside the long wall. Okay, so we need to calculate the weight of the soil on this much portion. So what we can do, we can calculate the weight of soil on whole of this portion minus the weight in this shaded tank region, and that will give you the weight on the projected portion only. So we deduct the whole volume minus this volume to get the volume of the soil on this projected portion, and then we multiply it with the density of soil to get the weight. So here I have done the same thing. So the outer area will be 10.7 plus 2x into 4.7 plus 2x, which is the area of your base slab, minus 10.7 into 4.7, area of the top slab, into 4, into 4 because we are calculating the volume. So the height of this will be 4 meter. Okay, you don't need to add 0.15 meter because we don't know that it is on the ground surface or below the ground surface. Okay, it will not create much difference. And into density will be 16 minus 10 because it is the saturated unit, saturated soil, so we will use the submerged unit weight. Okay, so now we get this as the weight of your soil on the projected portion. So this will help us to counteract the weight of your upward soil pressure. Okay, so this is the weight. Now we have got all the downwards weight, we will calculate the upward weight. So upward weight will be the pressure acting on this point and to the area. So as we have already calculated the pressure previously, let me show you here. The pressure acting per meter square of this particular on this particular base slab is 43.5. So what will be the total load? It will be pressure into area. So pressure into area is 43.5 into area of your base slab. So we will get this expression for your upward soil pressure. So total upward upliftment force or upward soil pressure is this, and total downward force is, if you add all these, we get this expression. Okay, you will have to add all the downward weights, and we get this expression. And now from stability point of view, the when will be our slab or our slab stable? When the total upliftment force is getting balanced by the downward force. So to prevent upliftment, the upward soil force or the upliftment force must be equal to the downward force. So we equate both these downward and upward force, and we solve this to get the value of x, which is the projection beyond the wall face. So I'm getting it to be 0.55, so I take it projection to be 0.6 meter. So now we have got this unknown quantity, which is 0.6. So we have all the dimensions of your underground tank. Okay, so now what we do, now that we have all the dimensions, we will calculate the load, we will make the load diagram, and from that load diagram we will calculate the moments and forces acting on the base slab for which the reinforcement has to be provided. Now which are the, okay, so we have already calculated the load weights, but we need the loads in kilonewton per meter square or kilonewton per meter for calculation of moments. Okay, so now we have not considered one value, one type of force here, that is the earth pressure, and another, that is the water pressure. Why? Because as I have explained to you earlier, we take these both forces, that is the outer earth pressure and the inner water pressure, separately, and then we calculate the moments and forces and reinforcement, and then combine those two. So up to now we have already calculated the weights and the upward soil pressure. Now what we will do, like in the design of long walls and short walls, we will take two cases. First we will consider only earth pressure, and then we will consider only the soil pressure, water pressure, and then we will calculate the moments and forces due to those. So first I am taking the first case, that is tank is empty, that is there is no water pressure, only the earth active forces acting. Okay, so now as we are calculating the soil pressure on the base slab, that will be the, we have calculated the upward soil pressure here, 43.5, somewhere here, 43.5, but we are now bothered only of the base slab. So this pressure acting on the net pressure acting on the slab will be the upward soil pressure acting on the base slab, that was this 10 into gamma into h plus t, minus the weight of your minus, this is basically the weight in kilonewton per meter square of the base slab, 25 into 0.35. okay, so we will get the net pressure as acting on the slab as 34.75 kilonewton per meter square. Another pressure we have is the soil pressure on the projected portion. Okay, so the projected portion soil pressure will be gamma into height. We have already calculated the weight here of the projected portion, but we are not bothered about that now, because we have to calculate in kilonewton per meter square, because we will be making the load diagram. So the load weight of the soil on projected portion will be 64 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so this is the first weight, this is the second weight. So by now we have calculated the upward soil pressure and the weight upward, so the downward pressure of the soil projected on the projection. Okay, now we calculate, there will be another weight acting on this particular base slab, that will be the downward weights due to long wall, short wall, top slab, etc. So I have calculated this weight here in one line only, that is the load transferred from wall and top slab to the base slab. So that will be weight of 1 meter long wall. Okay, so that will be 0.35 into 4. As we are calculating in per meter, therefore we need not multiply the length. So 0.35 is the thickness of long wall and 4 is the thickness, the height of long wall, into 25 will give you the long wall length, and the short wall length will be half into 4 point, sorry, the weight of the roof slab will be 4.7 into 0.15, because here, let me make the diagram, show you the diagram first. The length of your roof slab will be 4.7 meter and its thickness is 0.15 meter. So we will get this particular portion, and half is because the these forces are distributed half on each part. Okay, so I've done here for half, so R will be 43.85 kilometer. So this R is the combination of the loads of tank walls and the upper top slab. So first load, second load, third load we are getting. So this third load is this much. Half is acting on both the walls. Now next is the active earth pressure. So here we are taking the case A of active earth pressure. So we will calculate the pressure at the bottom of your here. So it is coming out to be 48 and the force is coming out to be 96. Okay, and it will act at h by 3 from the top, now from the bottom. So this we have calculated earlier also. So these are now the different forces. So we get this particular load diagram. This is the upward soil pressure. This is the soil pressure on the projected portion. This is the load acting from the top soil and the walls to the base, this much. And one another load is the soil lateral active earth pressure, as we are considering case A when there is only earth pressure is acting. So this calculation we have done earlier, that in the previous slide here. So 48 is the maximum earth pressure at base and 96 is the lateral active earth force acting at a distance of h by 3. Now we have this loading diagram. Now what we intend to do, so let me explain to you here. Now this is a base slab, okay. So we need to provide reinforcement in this base slab. So if you look at it carefully, it is almost like a continuous beam, okay, acted upon by these loads and these loads. Okay, there are vertical downward as well as upward loads acting on this beam. So what we will do, we will calculate the moments due to these loads in this way. So as if you recall the combined footing design of rectangular combined footing, if you remember, we studied in that case that the bending moment can be maximum at two more than one place, that is either it can be maximum near the support, that is in that case that was the column, and in other case it can be near the central span. So what we here also, if you look at it in a different way, it is also like looking like a combined footing. So this is the base slab of the combined footing and these are the columns. Imagine these are that. So we can say that moment can be maximum near the support also, that is here the support is the wall, and the moment can be maximum here also near the bottom of the span. So we will calculate both these moments, and then whatever is the maximum moment, we will do the calculations on the basis of that. So first of all, we will calculate the moment at the face of the tank wall. So you can calculate here or here. So if you calculate the moment at this point, note here that this portion of your slab is acting like a cantilever, okay, because this is free end. So here this one force is this and second force is this, so we calculate the moment due to these two forces also. So and third force is this also, the little earth pressure acting on the tank. So due to these three forces we calculate moment here, so we will call this as the cantilever moment, because this portion of the slab is acting like a cantilever. So first moment we calculate here. Now second moment we will calculate at the center, okay, because we are calculating at center because it is a symmetrical section, okay. So here also same load is acting, here also this load is similar to this load, and these dimensions are similar to these dimensions, so this is a symmetrical section, hence we can say that the bending moment will be maximum at its center. So we calculate the moment here and here, and we then provide reinforcements and calculate the thickness according to these moments. So I have briefed you, now we will be doing this. So we calculate moment at the face of wall, which we call as cantilever moment. Now make sure that this cantilever moment is not in the vertical direction, but it is acting in the base slab here. So the moment at cantilever, at for example I'm considering this section, or you can take this section also, the value will be same. So if you see this diagram, the moment will be, this value is 34.75, so 34, the moment due to 34.75 kilonewton per meter load will be 34.75 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2. Let me show you here, this load is 34.75. This is your projected portion of slab. This load is 34.75 acting on 0.6 meter. So the moment due to this force at this point will be 34.75 into this length into half of this length, because this is a UDL. So 34.75 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2. Minus this load is in another direction and this load is in different direction, so the moment will be like this for this load and like this for this load, okay. So we can say these, so we calculate this moment, this particular moment as 64 kilonewton per meter square is also acting in 0.6 meter length, so due to this force will be 64 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2, but in opposite direction, so minus sign. Along with it, another force is acting, that is the active earth pressure. So this is acting at this particular point. So now that we are calculating the moments at the slab, so we will be calculating the moment at the bottom of slab. So this load is acting at a height of h by 3 from this length, from this point, that is the from the base of wall. This is h by 3. So the total length lever arm of this load will be h by 3 plus the depth of this base slab. So h by 3 plus 0.35, I have calculated it previously here also, h by 3 plus 0.35 from bottom of the base slab, which is coming out to be 1.68 meter. So here we are taking 1.68. now this cantilever moment we calculated, and this moment at cantilever portion of base slab will lead to tension on the outer face, or not outer face but the bottom face of the slab, okay, because this is upward force will be dominate this particular case, so can dominate it, so the tension will be on the bottom face, so we will get this much this behavior, and tension will be on the in the bottom face. So when we are calculating the reinforcement due to cantilever, this cantilever moment, it will be provided on the bottom face. Now moment at the center of slab, now we intend to calculate the moment at this point, okay. Now I will erase all the other diagrams. So we are calculating the moment here, so individually take one end each force, so 34.75 is the total load. Now we have to calculate the moment at this point. So 34.75 is acting on this particular length, so 34.75 into this length will be 4 by 2 plus 0.35 plus 0.6. So 4 by 2 is 2 plus 0.35 plus 0.6. This is the total load. 34.375 is the UDL. So this is the total load into its distance from here will be the centroid of this UDL will be at the center. So its distance from this point will be the lever arm will be 34. This 4 by 2 plus this divided by 2. So this we get the moment due to the upward force. Then we calculate the moment due to the lateral force. So this will be 96 into 4 by 3 plus 0.35 as we did in the previous up here also. Now there is another force. This force we have done. Now due to this load or this load, you can I'm taking this direction here. So 43.81 into this will be 0.35 by 2 plus 4 by 2. So 4 by 2 plus 0.35 by 2 minus 64. 64 is the UDL, the 64 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2 plus 0.35 plus 4 by 2. So this will give you the lever arm for this force. And we calculate all these moments to get the moment at the center. That is 115.78 kilonewton meter. Okay, so here this is the moment we are getting at the center. Now this was for the first case when we have on the water earth pressure acting on the tank. Now we will take the second case when tank is full as no active earth pressure, that is there is no outside pressure. So first we calculate the maximum earth pressure at base, which will be gamma W into H, and the force due to this will be half into gamma W H into capital H. So we are getting it to be 80 kilonewton. So the moment at center due to this force will be 34.75 into now. What we are doing, we are calculating the moment here due to all these loads. Okay, again we are doing the same thing. So 34.75 into 34.75 is the upward load. So 34.75 into 4 by 2 plus 0.35 plus 0.6. This will give the total length of the UDL into same 4 by 2 plus 0.35 plus 0.6 divided by 2. So we can get this here. It is same as done here also. Okay, now we will calculate this particular now on the differences. Here we were taking the lateral earth force, now we will take the inside water pressure. So the moment due to this will be in the opposite direction. So I have written here minus sign. So 80 into 4 by 3 plus 0.35 minus 64 into 0.6 into 0.35 plus 4 by 2 minus 43.8 plus 0.35 by 2 plus 4 by 2. So we get all these forces and get the moment at the center. So this will lead to the tension at top. So you can see here that the sign here is showing whether the tension will be at bottom or at top, because as there are different types of loads here in different directions, you cannot decide whether the moment will be at in the bottom or top. Just by looking at the diagram, you will have to find the proper sign. So as it is positive moment, so it will lead to sagging and tension at bottom, and as it is at it is the negative moment, it will be leading to tension at the top. Okay, now we are not calculating here. Okay, so the now we calculate the cantilever moment at the face of wall. So either here or here, either anywhere you can calculate. So that will be, I am calculating here, 64 into 34.75 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2 minus 64 into 0.6 into 0.6 by 2. As it is coming out to be very less, hence we will ignore this for sure, because the reinforcement due to this particular moment will be very, very less. Okay, so you can ignore this. In some books, this part is also skipped because this is very less moment. Okay, why we are not taking any other load here? Because in the previous case, when we are calculating the moment here, cantilever moment here, this force was acting, that is the lateral force. But here, there is no force acting on the outside, and as we are calculating the moment here, there will be no effect from the water pressure on this particular face. So now we have got these four moments from case A, that is when PA is not equal to zero, that is when only active earth pressure is acting. We are getting cantilever moment as positive, and this is also positive, and cantilever moment here it was a negative, and we have ignored this, and moment at center is negative. Okay, so we got all these moments. Now we will calculate the maximum moment. The maximum moment here is 180. We see the value, not the sign. So the moment is 180. So as you know, in the first step of the design of base slab, we assumed the thickness of base slab to be 350 mm. So we have to check whether we have taken it to be right or not. So the thickness required to carry this 180 kN moment is coming out to be 346 effective thickness. Therefore, provide total thickness of 400 mm with 50 mm cover. So we are getting the small ds 350 mm, okay, and capital ds 400. Now you can change do the calculations for this particular value. So now we will do the reinforcement calculation for this case and this case. For case A, the cantilever moment was this and the central moment was this. So reinforcement due to cantilever moment at the face of wall was is coming out to be AST is equal to M upon sigma ST JD, and we check it with the AST minimum, and this is AST minimum is 1400 and we are getting 3994, so obviously we will adopt this value. So provide 25 mm dia bar at 120 mm center to center at bottom face near the face of wall in the base slab. So where we are in calculating this reinforcement, let me show you. If this is your base slab, this is the face of wall, we are calculating this reinforcement around here and around here near the face of wall at the bottom portion. Okay, then reinforcement due to the positive moment at center of slab due to it was coming out to be 115.78. so we calculate the reinforcement due to this, and it is coming out to be 25 mm dia bars at 160 mm center to center at the bottom face of slab near the center of base slab. Okay, because it is positive moment, so there will be tension on the bottom face, so we are getting this reinforcement near the center. Okay, so near the center of your base slab. So in the bottom portion of bottom face of the central area, and in the corner area we are getting this reinforcement at the face near the face of wall at the bottom face due to cantilever moment. So I hope you get this is the reinforcement for case A. Now for case B, the cantilever moment was coming out to be quite less, so we ignore that and just provide minimum reinforcement. I will show you how this reinforcement is provided for the cantilever moment here. So for now we have ignored this. Now the reinforcement due to the central moment and negative central moment at the center was 180.46, and AST was coming out to be 4611. So the reinforcement is 25 mm dia bars at 100 mm center to center at the top face of slab near the center of base slab. So for this case, what we are getting as it is a negative bending moment, so the tension will be on the top here. So the central reinforcement is provided on the top portion, okay. And if we consider the cantilever moment, the cantilever moment is also coming out to be negative. So the reinforcement, as this is cantilever, the reinforcement will be on the top only, but we will ignore it because the reinforcement will be quite less. So what we do, we will not obviously keep this portion empty, so we will just extend some of this reinforcement up to here, and some of the reinforcement we will confine to the central portion. So extended alternate reinforcement towards face of wall so that this portion does not remain empty. So we extend this reinforcement near the corners. So now we have got all this reinforcement. First is this corner reinforcement due to case A near the face of wall at the bottom face, central reinforcement due to at the bottom face due to case A, and then we have another reinforcement, central reinforcement at top due to case B, and this reinforcement we are extending to the corners or to the faces of wall so that this portion does not remain vacant. So this much reinforcement we have calculated. Now what about the as this is a slab, what about the other direction? In other direction we don't do any calculation, we just provide the minimum amount of reinforcement in the form of distribution steel. So as it is, minimum steel is coming out to be 1400. I have calculated it in the previous slides. So we provide half of this in both the faces along the longer direction. So 700 mm square reinforcement is provided on both the faces on the opposite direction. So it will look like this in the form of circles. You can represent it on the top face as well as the bottom face. So I have made this diagram here. Now let us revise this diagram. So in the bottom central portion we were getting this reinforcement due to case A. In the corner wall near the face of wall we were getting this reinforcement at both the faces of walls. This was due to case A. Due to case B we were getting negative reinforcement, and this will lead to negative reinforcement at the top in the central portion, and as the cantilever movement here was very less, so we just extended this reinforcement towards this the corner so that this portion does not remain vacant. And what about the other direction? We provide minimum reinforcement of 10 mm diameter at 100 mm center to center on both the faces, top as well as bottom. So this is the L section along the short wall of base slab, and this will be the L section along long wall here, along the longer direction of the base slab. So here we are providing the distribution reinforcement along the longer direction, which is calculated here. So these lines are showing that reinforcement, and all these other reinforcements are the reinforcement along the shorter direction. Like in the middle portion we have 25 at 100 center to center at the top, and in the corner portion we have 25 die at 200 center to center. Okay, so this has been represented by these dots here. And in the bottom portion we have in the central region 25 die at 160 center to center. So these are those reinforcement, and 25 at 120 in the corner portion. So this is all about the detailing of your base slab. So now we have completed all the components of your tank, starting from top slab, long wall, short wall, and then finally the base slab. So I have prepared just one cross section of your tank along the shorter direction, so that you can get an idea of whatever we have calculated till now. This is the cross section. So along the short wall, so I think this should be, I have written here wrong, this should be long wall. So these are the reinforcements in the long wall which we have calculated previously. You can check it in the long wall portion. Here we had the vertical reinforcements as the main reinforcement, and we had curtailed it twice, 25 at 320, 20 at 320, 160 and 80, and similarly on the inner face also. And there was horizontal reinforcement due to compression and tension. So this was the long wall, and now the base slab we have explained to you here in the previous slide, and in the top slab we had the main reinforcement along the shorter direction and the distribution reinforcement along the longer direction, and we can bend up some bars and take it towards the top portion near the corners so that when any negative moment appear at the supports, so they can counteract that. Okay, so you can, I have drawn it here also. So this is all about the rectangular tank, underground tank design. Although it is quite lengthy, but if you understand the small concepts and if you think on each point properly, so it will be very easy for you to understand. You just have to consider and visualize the loads acting on each component and the behavior due to those loads on that components, whether it is long wall or short wall or base slab. Now similarly, if this question was for L by B greater than 2, now similarly you can do the same question when L by B less than 2. All the things will be same, except when you design the long walls and short walls. When L by B is less than 2, then both long wall and short wall behave in a similar way. Okay, so that portion will be different. Rest of the design of top slab and base slab will be exactly same. So I hope you have understood this topic.